So dermatomyositis is part of a heterogeneous collection of rare diseases called idiopathic inflammatory myopathies or autoimmune myopathies. But in few words, dermatomyositis is a disease that affects the skin and the muscle. It can affect the skin and cause a characteristic skin rash, which means that when we see it, we know that this is dermatomyositis. It's usually in sun-exposed areas, like it can cause a V-shaped rash of the upper chest, a saw-like sign over the upper back, over the knuckles or the elbows. It reminds us of someone being out in the sun and having a suntan. But in reality, this is just the skin rash of dermatomyositis. And it can also affect the face, and especially the eyelids. That comes from a dilatation of the vessels in the area. People can also have an erythematous rash of the face that is called malar rash. And this is something that we can see in lupus as well. But the difference between the two diseases is that in dermatomyositis, it can affect the whole face, whereas in lupus, it spares the nasolabial folds. So the rash is limited to this area, but in dermatomyositis, it can affect the whole face. While skin rash is characteristic for dermatomyositis, and that's why it's called dermatomyositis from derm, it can also have symptoms similar to polymyositis, like muscle weakness. People can develop proximal muscle weakness, which means the shoulders, biceps, triceps, and the thighs. They feel weak. They suddenly see that they cannot climb up the stairs, they have difficulty, or they have to use their arms in order to get up from a chair or their bed. When they try to comb their hair, they cannot keep their arms high enough to complete the task. Lastly, another organ that it can be very important and can be affected in dermatomyositis is the lungs, where the patients can develop what is called interstitial lung disease. That means that the lungs are inflamed and can lead to fibrosis. That has a consequence that the lung is not able to absorb the oxygen from the air.